Hey guys, how's it going? It's Mr. Q here, and I'm back at you again with another video. I am on my way back to sleep, and I want to talk about a revelation and a sign from the dream that I had about the bear. So I just gave a testimony yesterday morning. You know, I was in the middle of nowhere in this particular dream I had a few days ago, and I decided to post yesterday morning when I was inside of the Best Western. I spoke of tire going flat, and I was saying it's getting dark outside. I'd rather be inside the car than be outside. Stuck with a bike was what I was saying. And then all of a sudden, a racing thought, a shooting thought just came and said, I was concerned about the bears. You know, in the area I was in, with bears. Inside, didn't know if it was woods or not. If bears hang in woods, I'm not knowledgeable until I researched what God showed me, right? So, I'm down here in Austin, Texas, and I was down here for my daughter's birthday, and didn't have a lot of time to do a lot of stuff, but just to do the birthday party. But, spending a little bit of time with my mom, and I came back to the house, and she agreed to take me back to Dallas tomorrow. But the reason why I'm just kind of like stopping and pausing is because what I'm about to say is very, 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 shocking. I dreamed of the bears, and I'm laying on the couch because I have to lay here. I didn't run out of room. I'm in my mom's house right now, and she has like little quilts. One quilt is like Dallas Cowboys, another one is like, a picture of the bottom of the sea with a whale on it, and it's like tucked in the couch. You know, people, they tuck covers over their couch pillows at the bottom when you sit down. So I've been here at the house about 2 hours, going on three. And I'm resting, and I'm just like, I gotta pray before I go to sleep. Pray over the couch and bless it with the blood of Jesus. And so I get up, I go use the restroom, I come back. And, I'm observant, very observant around my surroundings. And so I'm looking at the cover, and I'm squinting it real hard. And as I look really, really hard, I go, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. I begin to shape out and paint the face of a bear. So there's a cover quilt, thin quilt tucked in on the couch I'm sleeping on. It's the long couch of my mom's house. And it's a quilt tucked on the couch, which causes me to lay upon it. And I didn't see it at first, but I took a step back and I looked, and it's one of a real, real big bear. So I may have to do a video of the revelation of a picture so you guys can see it. And then I'll just stop the video there. I'll just say this is the revelation of the bear and the dream, and I had this dream, and then now I see this bear. But I definitely believe that God is talking to me about the future, and I need to keep my eyes open. I believe that the Lord is talking to me, about perilous times coming up, dangerous times that I'm going to have to take off. There's going to be a day that I'm going to have to take off. I got to leave all else behind and be on the good foot. I got to be on the good foot, and I got to be on the go. And I got to go. And it just seems prevalent in the future that I will encounter bears, man. And it's crazy because think about this in the dream. I'm like, I'd rather be inside of the car. Now, when I left the Greyhound, I needed to get a cab or a Lyft. The Lyft never got picked up. And there was people roaming around, you know, and one guy, sleep, I was telling one guy I need a ride. He was like, I'm busy, I'm about to go use the restroom. But you can talk to the guy over here. I'm like, where? And he's like, over there. And then I look, and then I'm like, wait a minute, I'm walking upon this guy. And he's asleep in the back seat. He's asleep in the back seat of his car. And I knocked on the window because I was about to say, I need a ride from him. But something was just like, no, don't do that. You know, catch a cab, another cab from a more legit person. So I did. But all of these signs around me, I'm paying attention and I'm feeling uncomfortable in my spirit, you know, because something's telling me that this is real. Everything that I'm experiencing, you know, it's not a coincidence that, you know, I'm sleeping on this quilted cover tucked in the couch that I'm laying on tonight, that I will be going to sleep. And then, you know, it's such a crazy thing from the dream, and it's getting nighttime, and I know I need to go to sleep, and I was concerned about bears. I was concerned. I remember going, make sure that the window is all the way up on the car. I don't know if you guys ever seen or heard or seen a movie, but bears are very smart. If you've seen a movie before, they can topple over a car. They can pry and rip off the top of the roof to get in if they're hungry enough. They can open up a can. They can open up some stuff. They're smart. They can shake a car. They can do things. They can, you know, get into things. They're very smart. And bears can also, if you're like somewhere, you know, they can run up on you. You can get tired. But if it's more than one, you're in trouble. Because they can stand up, you know, and just overpower you. Or they can let off a growl. Or that's going to really, really just scare the mess out of you. And you better have a gun. But if you're out in the open with a bear in the woods, you know, once they pin you down, one of the things they start going for is your head. And you may hear this crackle sound. It may sound like somebody eating ice, but that means that they got to your skull, and they cracked it open. And they just start cracking on it, and, you know, They begin to eat, you know, you're right. But this is a sign. I really hate to be, you know, so blunt. I apologize tonight. But I just can't let this, you know, sit in my spirit correctly, because, you know, you can have a dream and someone thinks you're crazy, but when you have a dream and you see something in the natural, that's when this goes to a whole nother level. And that's where I'm at. That's what I'm trying to tell you. So I'm just like, whoa, whoa, and whoa. Okay? And it's at my mom's house on the couch, this cover. I will show you this cover. I'll make a little short video to show you this cover, so you can know I'm telling the truth. But this is definitely a warning for me in the future. Definitely a warning, and definitely something I need to be praying about. Maybe God is going, because what the Lord reveals, he heals. If God shows something ahead of time, he could be like, this is not something that you want to do. This is not something that you want to encounter. You know, you don't want to be living in the woods, you know, you're not going to make it there, or something dangerous, or you would have to encounter bears or whatever. You know, you would need like basically a 12-gauge shotgun. Or you better make sure that you puncture the heart of this bear. You know, if it gets to you and starts messing with your car, because they top of that sucker like it's a football. They fumble it. And they're really aggressive ones and the ones that are hungry. So, I wanted to leave this with you guys. I'm taking heed to what God is saying. I feel like sometimes there's avenues that, you know, you don't need to go down, and God is like, pray, do this, do that. I'm showing you the future. I'm showing you how you can change it now and be wise, be better, do this, do that. So, or what if I had to go somewhere underground and I had to travel through a place with a whole bunch of woods? You know what I mean? Or if I had to park on the side of the road, or I had to hide my car because I'm running from the military law, and I'm in the woods somewhere hiding, and I got my car parked until it's morning. And let's say I got a flat, but I'm on my way, you know, to somewhere where I can hide on the ground, but I didn't make it there yet. And I encounter this, and I got to survive that night, and let's just say a bear came, and I had to survive that to keep going. So that's how I think. That's exactly how I think. And, another way that I think is, if you see something unique you don't like in a dream, or you feel or sense something in the natural, just pray about it. But you guys be blessed. I'm going to sleep. And I'll talk to you guys soon. Good night.